Hello, everyone. Today, I want to give you a quick overview of a few new features that are included in the Dynamics 365 Marketing 2020 Release Wave 1. Now, key investment areas for this release are personalized marketing with improved segment design and templates, email usability improvements, and an email preview header. Also, an improved event management experience, including a consistent forms experience, integration with third-party websites, and improvements to reoccurring events. Our scenario here is that we're getting ready for a big product launch, so we're going to do a pilot of our customer journey. We'll start by targeting our pilot campaign only to customers from one city who we've already classified as engaged. And then we'll build a dynamic email for our customers. Well, let's see how this all works. First, we have to define our customer segment. We need to identify our customers who've engaged with our past marketing campaigns. So we start by opening the Contoso Winter Collection journey. And we review the data on the emails that were sent out in the past. We're specifically interested in the contacts that have opened emails. We can work with the data here in marketing, or we can take all of these interactions and save them to Excel, where we can do additional analysis. We then build our own launch pilot by creating a dynamic segment from customers who are in the city of Seattle and who have opened one of the winter collection emails. Now we're also adding a handpicked set of customers that we've labeled premium resellers. We have the option to edit these segments, and we'll use that option to dive into the premium resellers segment and add one more person to the record. Now notice that marketing warns us that this is a live record and it's in use by another campaign. This warning is extremely valuable when you have multiple people working in parallel. And as we start to add our additional premium reseller, marketing gives us a list of our available contacts to choose from. Now, this is a pilot customer journey, so we'll want to use this model for events in other cities. So to support this, we'll save this segment as a template. And once the template is created, we can add guidance to the text box, like intercity names, so the rest of the team can easily use this template for other events in other cities. Now let's take a look at the emails that we're going to send out. It's important that all marketing emails have a consistent branding and messaging. So we start by selecting a template. And with the new labeling option, we can see that this one has the layout enabled, and this one is new. So we select our template. And with the new drag and drop, I can quickly resize items. I can navigate the hierarchy from button to column layout, where I can use the new color picker to set the background. And I can enter text with a highlight so that it shows against the image. And I'll add a dynamic section to include the contact's name. This email formatting is great, but people decide to open an email while it's still in their inbox. So we've added preview text that shows before they open it. This text can also include dynamic content, and it encourages the customer to open the full email. And the result looks like this in their inbox. And when they open it, they see our fully formatted email with the personalized dynamic content. Now let's talk about the event management improvements in Dynamics 365 Marketing 2020 Release Wave 1. Now, Contoso is about to do a product launch, so we'll have multiple events, each with its own signup form. And we want to set up a reoccurring series of training events for our own people. Let's see how this all works. We'll start with the Contoso Black Tie Dinner event that we want our event resellers to attend. And we have a registration form that we've developed that we want to embed in a third-party page. Here you see the details of the JavaScript that marketing has generated to embed our form in that page. The key here is that you don't need to reformat that page. You're just getting the form embedded. So this is how our form looks in that third-party web page. And if we go look at the source of this page, we can see the JavaScript that links to our form. Now we also need to set up some internal training for the team. So we'll set up a reoccurring weekly event. We can also view these training meetings as a list of events. And after reviewing and adjusting each of these events, if required, we select Go Live, and each event will individually and sequentially go live. As you've seen, key investment areas for the 2020 release Wave 1 update to Dynamics 365 marketing include personalized marketing with improved segment design and templates, email usability improvements, and an email preview header. Also, an improved event management experience, including a consistent forms experience, integration with third-party websites, and improvements to reoccurring events. For more information, use these specific links or go to the Release Overview Guide.